All right, everybody, welcome back here to Jordan-Hare Stadium, auburnundercover.com, the Auburn Undercover YouTube channel. Jason Caldwell, I'm Nathan King. My goodness.
I was thinking about it like we're walking out here. I mean, it's honestly one where you just really know what to say.
It's unbelievable.
To do everything you had to do to win a football game. You ran the football, made plays when you had to on defense. Put yourself in a position to do it, and then a couple plays the difference.
Yep.
And it's bad to say that, but the muff punt return, 4th and 31. You make either one of those plays, and you're probably walking out of here a winner, and you're storming the field in the process, and it didn't happen.
Well, we drew a bunch of parallels to the 2001 Iron Bowl. By the way, Auburn 27-24 loses the Iron Bowl here inside Jordan-Hare Stadium with a crazy 4th and 31 play. We'll get to all of that. We assume that everybody has already watched all that and knows everything about that. We were drawing parallels to 2021, and that game, Jason, Alabama made just enough more plays than Auburn did. Mm-hmm. Auburn was down. They were injured. They really had no chance. This felt like a similar game, except in the way that I thought Auburn outplayed Alabama.
Correct.
For most of the – I mean, Alabama had 5 straight drives from the second quarter to the fourth quarter that totaled 3 points.
Yeah.
But it was that fifth drive that ended in the muff punt. And so, like you said, it really came down to, look, Auburn put together the performance you wanted in this game on both sides of the ball. I thought the offense and the run game were really, really strong. The defense clamped down when they needed to. But just a couple plays ended up making the difference. And obviously 4th and 31 now is going to be something that's going to be one of Alabama's most memorable Iron Bowls.
It is.
Something they point to for a long
time. It is. And honestly, I asked Hugh Freeze about it after the game. Still not sure that's the way I would have approached it. But as he said, he's like, look, you got 9 guys there, 8 guys that are watching the quarterback. Even the ninth would have been Eugene Asante, who was kind of there in the middle. You still got 8 guys knowing that you got to get it to the end zone. And the problem was that once you scrambled around so long, DJ James and those guys started trailing and tailing guys instead of kind of just keeping their eyes on the quarterback. And so all it took was one play. Jalen Milroe was probably the difference in this game.
Absolutely.
When you look at what he was able to do in a run game, extend plays. Auburn gave up a 4th and goal at the 31 and a 3rd and 17 in this game alone. And so you start talking about some of those big plays they were able to make on some of those situations. And it was huge. And you're right, Nathan, everything we said Auburn had to do to win the game, they did.
Yep.
But again, you can't make those kind of mistakes in those situations, and teams are going to make you pay.
Yeah, a couple of them. Peyton Thorne's interceptions were fourth half, didn't matter. End of the game, didn't
Correct.
Matter. At the end of the day, still 3 turnovers to Alabama, 0 in this game. Milroe, absolutely. The difference, I thought he was supremely impressive in this game. And, that was probably the only part of Auburn's defensive game plan that didn't work out very consistently. They chose to pressure less, thinking that, okay, we're not going to get that much with 3. Let's just drop everybody back and try to go in coverage. The problem with that, really, until that play, was that he had so many openings. Even the 3rd and 20 mm-hmm. on that drive, he didn't convert it, but he makes it a 4th and 1 and makes it something that is convertible on the next play.
Correct.
So many I think it was 107 rushing yards for him, but it felt like every time Auburn dropped those guys back, he had 7 or 8 free rushing yards before anyone was even in his vicinity. And that was, on a day where the Auburn defense did a lot of what it was supposed to do. Like you said, he ended up being the difference.
The Auburn's front, and you go, okay, pick your poison. Do you blitz and then have to play man and turn your back and risk giving up, 60, 70-yard touchdown runs? Or do you say, look, what we're not going to do is let him beat us running the football? And even then he did it. And I thought it was really more lack of containment on the ends than it was necessarily the plan. The plan, I thought, was, hey, keep him in the pocket.
Yep.
And too many times guys got too far upfield or got caught inside, and when he broke it outside, there was nobody there. So if you do one, you can't do both. And too many times for Auburn, it was both. They tried to contain, and they lost contain at the same time. And that was huge. Offensively, after a tough early start, I thought Peyton Thorne played pretty well. He threw it much better in the second half. They dialed up some really good things offensively in the second half. And, the running game was the key. Peyton ran it well. Jarquez, Demari Austin.
285 yards.
285 before sack yards. So 244 net rushing yards against that Alabama defense. It's hard to ask a whole lot more from what they did offensively. And again, a couple of key drops. Now, right here, Javaris Johnson, that would have been a tough play on the back end line. But, Rivaldo Fairweather, one ball is underthrown, but still needs to be caught.
He's
another one he had over the middle that would have converted a 3rd down that you didn't make a play on. So, not quite enough for a team that is, we've seen that before, just not quite enough for them.
I thought Auburn, their response early on was stellar. I mean, this was the first couple drives for Auburn. I mean, you obviously had the face mask that was a missed call that put them in a bad spot in their second drive, but Alabama went up, they scored, Auburn went two and out, three and out, two straight drives, yep. And it was like, man, this looks kind of rough. Bama scored on the fourth and one before that was called back, and I thought Auburn's response from there, that's when they started running the ball. Those two drives, I think it was eight plays, 160 yards on those two drives. Yeah. All of it was runs by Jarquez Hunter and Damari Alston. You mentioned Peyton Thorne, I think 3 of 3 for 71 yards and a touchdown in the third quarter.
Yes.
And so that was after he was 2 of 10 in the first half. So Free said it after the game. He said, look, we didn't really change anything as the game went on.
Just executed.
It was just a matter of executing that game plan. But the questionable slash, I guess, you know, really brutal play there at the end was Coy Moore's muff punt. And, I mean, 4:48 remaining, Auburn would have had a chance to choose some clock.
Alabama has three timeouts left.
Yes.
You're probably not taking them at that moment.
Right. So you may not have scored.
Yeah. But. Yeah. But if you could, you know, if you get two first downs right there, you're probably in the game. And the way Auburn was moving the football right there, you might have had a chance to do that. Again, it's just unfortunate. And you know, we don't know why it was Coy Moore instead of Keontae Scott. But, you know, and hey, nobody, I promise you, nobody feels worse than Coy Moore does. We heard he was still in the locker room really late after this game. You know, that's one of those moments that it's an unfortunate part of it. You know, he loses his footing and you're like, hey, on hindsight, you probably just go, hey, just try to get out of the way as much as possible and try to make a catch, and it didn't work out.
If you're going to have miraculous plays, if you're going to have huge moments, and especially in a rivalry game like this, somebody is going to be on the other side of it. That's how football works. Even DJ James, he had a stellar game. Yep. Absolutely fantastic. He'll be an NFL draft pick. He'll be playing in the league for the next 15 years. But every time that highlight plays, he's going to find himself on the TV screen.
He is, and it's an unfortunate ending to what was a really good football game for Auburn.
Yeah.
To play as well as they did. And you know, Hugh Freeze said it tonight. Somebody asked about, hey, what do you take from being right there with Georgia and Alabama this year? And he said, look, in the end, it's about wins and losses. And that's true. But there's no question that you look and you go, did you see a step? Yeah, we saw steps. Do you need to get better? Absolutely. And that includes coaching, but talent level, everything about it, execution. Because, you know, the execution is on that last play, hey, you got a bunch of guys that are watching the football. Just make them throw it and then go knock it down. Didn't happen that way. And so, comes up a little short on a night when everything was primed for Auburn to finish off this regular season in a big way.
Yeah, I mean, that perplexing, really, the way that final play turned. I mean, I think the probability of it is what I kept coming back to. I mean, how often are you going to convert a 4th and 31? Just unbelievable. Alabama had 5 pass catchers in the end zone. Auburn had 8 guys defending the football, and you're still able to not only score at the last minute, but
it wasn't a jump ball. Yep. Yes, I mean, it was just the throw.
And a spectacular throw for him to come across there. Yeah, I mean, that was the point I kind of clung to from Hugh Freeze afterwards. You know, the Georgia game wasn't as dramatic, but it still was a case of their players that are a lot more talented coming through in the very final stages to give their team a win. Obviously, it was a little bit more dramatic here with Alabama, but he said, you know, the message, talking about the recruits, obviously you and Christian hear a spectacular recruiting weekend for Auburn. His message to those recruits, which I understand probably still had a fantastic time at this game, the message is that, look, as heartbreaking as this is, Auburn feels like it is close to closing this gap against teams
like this. Yeah, I mean, player after player said that, and I've been to a lot of games here, been to a lot of Iron Bowls here. That atmosphere was as good as any of them. I mean, it was fantastic. You know, after a slow start, you know, we talked about it before the game, and it's funny because I actually talked to Hugh Freeze about it for a second, and I said, look, if you'll give this crowd a chance, they'll carry you along, and that happened. The crowd carried this team throughout the game. And I think it was a learning experience for them, for the new players that hadn't been a part of it, to see what you can do in this place when everything's going. Now, you got to just get better and get better on the field, on the sidelines. That's all a part of it.
As Auburn finishes here, and even 6-6 in the regular season, I think this game was, you know, at its core was an amalgamation of a lot of things we've seen from this team. Some good, some bad, lots of inconsistency, and feeling like you're just a step away from having the types of plays, the playmakers, the execution to be able to win games
like this. Yeah, and like I said, look at the last play.
Yep.
You know, you go, you got 3 guys up there. if Alabama is playing that same situation and they're rushing their three guys, they're probably able to get pressure at some point. That's the difference, is having those kind of guys that even in that situation, you go, we feel like we can get pressure. When you feel like no matter how many guys we send, we can't get enough pressure, then you have to resort to going, okay, what's our best course of action? And it was dropping everybody and you know, hoping you knock it down.
Yeah, this is one that we'll still obviously talk about for a while. It's one, like the player said after the game, it's going to sting for Auburn for quite some time. They had an opportunity here to close out the regular season on a high note. Instead, 6-6 in year one for Hugh Freeze. We will see, I guess, not this Sunday, but Sunday after, where they're going to go bowling. Incredible atmosphere. I mean, you absolutely could not beat the type of football that was played here tonight at Jordan-Hare Stadium. But Alabama ends up getting their miraculous, you know, 10 years after the kick six, they get a miraculous finish here in Jordan-Hare Stadium. 27-24, Alabama wins. For Jason Caldwell, Nathan King, thank you guys so much for joining us. Join us over at auburnundercover.com. We'll talk to you all soon.